Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm rendering exposition of John 12, verse 1 to 26. So, Mary anoints Jesus at Bethany. 6 days before the Passover, Jesus, therefore, came to Bethany, where Lazarus was, whom Jesus had raised from the dead. So they gave a dinner for him there. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those reclining with him at table. Martha, you know, she was once born, and she much appreciated what Jesus did for her brother. So she was very, very fond of, you know, Jesus. Whereas Lazarus and Mary, they were twice born, and they were, every word that came from Jesus, they were listening to him. They were very hungry to have the word of God. So that's why Mary always sat beside Jesus, and so Lazarus. Mary therefore took a, a twice born, took a pound of expensive ointment made from pure lard, nard, I think, you know it better than I can, and anointed the feet of Jesus and wiped his feet with a hair. This is very important, you know. The hair there on your head. If you want to honor somebody, we say somebody, we went to that house and he honored me, he put me over his head. That means he gave me great honor. So hair are honor of the person as they are over your head and not under your feet. We seek the dust of the feet of Christ Jesus. That means we want to be lowest, you know, we want to see the dust of the feet of Jesus. And we lower ourselves so much that our wisdom head here is foolish to that of Christ Jesus. So Mary was a person of spirit, or had Christ in her heart. The house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume. That is, Jesus was most welcome guest by Lazarus and his sisters. And that welcome perfume filled the whole house. So sometimes you get a guest, you know, you honor him so much, everybody is happy, you know, and then to welcome, to see him. But Judas Iscariot, one of his twice-born laborers, and not the once-born disciples of the rabbis, you know, this is a corruption by the Messianic Jews, so they wanted to keep you under the thumb, so that you are called disciple, and once you are disciple, then you are slave, then of the Lord. So he who was about to betray him said, he was a man, Mammon loving, you know, not God loving. Why was this ointment not sold for 300 denarii and given to the poor? A trick by the Mammon worshipper. If you go to the church, and sometimes most of them are good, you know, in the West, but sometimes people in East and also in the Africa, you know, they were the cheat people. They have these tricks, you know. He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief. This is a very good point. You have thieves in your churches and you don't know them because you are spiritually blind. Because he was a thief. And having charge of the purse of the money bag, he used to help himself to what was put into it. Today, these dog-collared hireling priests in churches are the copycats of Judas Iscariot, stealing money from the church purse at the end of month as their salary, as if they are working for Mammon and not for God. So they tell, you know, that to the with the dog collar, you know, when they put it on, simple man thing, he is a man of God, working for God. So if he is working for God, then he should get payment from our Father, not from Mammon. They love payment in Mammon and not in the gospel prayers that are freely received and freely given. Jesus said, "Leave her alone so that she may keep it for the day of my burial. For the poor you always have with you, but you do not always have me." Now Jesus knew it, and so his other laborers, they were happy to see that she anointed him, but not Lazarus, because Lazarus, having eye only expensive perfume, he hasn't seen before. So he was more of a money, you know, as sometimes you go to these churches, the dog-collar priest, they are hireling, you know, the Mammon. They are not working for God. They are hypocrites. Sometimes they will tell their one of the congregation people, if they find some rich one, "Oh, I want to go to travel, you know, on holiday, but I have no money. I spent this thing, that thing, you know. I wish if you can loan me some." So if somebody loans him the money, then he never pays it back. And this cheating had been going so bad, you know, that even some lady took somebody to court over £100,000. The priest had fleeced her off. So this is quite common. People who work for God, if you take money, then God won't give you anything. I print these t-shirts and I give them free. I don't charge money. But that people are there prepared to put it on. And because they are frightened what I have written on it. I agree with them, you know, if you do not understand, don't put it on. But I give it free, I don't charge it, you know. And this is my contribution to our Father. This is the living lampstand, and this is the light on living lampstand. If somebody will ask me what is written, I will explain. But hardly anybody is bothered, you know. And I have put too many text on the back, so that also deters them. However, always, you know, preach gospel with an open heart, and never, when you are doing the work for God, never look for money for as payment. I see some coming to these fellowships. They are much better churches, you know, because they don't have a dog-collar priest hireling. But they ask people to come to give lecture, you know. People come to give lecture from, say, 200 miles away, or 100 miles away, or 50 miles away. But when they go, they give them, put money in their pocket. And he happily accepts it. So he got the payment, so he must keep his customers happy, otherwise they won't invite him. As nobody wants to invite me, because my gospel is not sweet sugar-coated tablet, it's a bitter. So that such is the people, you know, the society has become. So unless you mend your way and get God orientated and not Mammon orientated, you won't have gospel in your heart. Gospel is written over your heart, not in the book. So our Father God blesses you.